Weekends for the Kumars involve visiting open homes, and they are loving it.
Yeah, we're finding good properties, and a lot of properties which were on auctions are currently out of auction without any unconditional buyers. So we have a chance to look for houses now.
A chance even a year ago they couldn't dream of.
The market is like in a way that like definitely you will have a chance, and you will also end up buying the one which you actually like, not compromise on anything.
Yeah.
So which most of our friends have done, they have compromised on something or other. But I think this time we have a very good chance.
The Wickmans are also on the house hunt. They are looking for an upgrade of their one-bedroom house.
It's a lot slower. Like this, you've not even got as many people going through the houses now, so you don't feel like there's as much competition.
The buyers hold the kind of control, I guess.
Those whose job it is to work on the seller's behalf say 2 years ago it was different groups taking an interest.
Mum and pop investor saying, what a great little investment, prices are going up, so let's grab it, and the poor old, you know, first-time buyers will be left behind. But that's not happening now.
The two major reasons that investors invest are either for capital growth or rental return, and at the moment they're unlikely to be seeing either of those, so that's keeping them out of the market.
So while all signs point to a buyer's market in Auckland, helped by continuing low interest rates, the trend's not showing up in other parts of the country. In fact, real estate data shows that record highs were recently reached in five parts of the country: Wellington, Manawatū, the Central North Island, Marlborough and Southland.
Where Auckland is right now, you can expect the rest of the country to follow over the next 18 months to 2 years.
Ashley Church says it's all part of the boom and bust cycle.
I think the areas where you might see some more significant drops are in areas where housing is more expensive, or in lower socioeconomic areas where investors were active during the property boom.
So what does it mean for sellers?
If you need to move on, then be prepared to accept what the market gets to.
It's going to take them a little bit longer to sell in a slow market.
Leaving the Kumar family.
Currently it's really good. Yeah. So yeah, grab what you could.
Hoping it's not too long before they have a home of their own. Katie Bradford, One News.